even in developed countries such as US, we would like farmers to do some practices which might perhaps not always produce the highest yield. The idea is not to maximize production, but to optimize production. Optimize means it may be 10% lower perhaps than the maximum, but it can be sustained forever. I think the same thing applies in developing countries. To do that, I think farmers should be given some incentive. And by incentivizing, I do not mean subsidies. Let me give an example. If we ask farmers to leave the crop residue back on the land, or use cover cropping, or some other system which build up soil organic matter content, sequester carbon in soil, then the farmers are generating ecosystem services, including climate change mitigation and adaptation, improving water quality, reducing algal bloom, which we have a serious problem in Ohio. And that farmer would do if they know that they are being compensated for what we are asking them to do. It's not a subsidy, it's not a handout, it's not a charity. It is something we have requested them to do for the global community. We have 500 to 600 million small farmers, such as the farm on which I grew up, in Africa, Asia, elsewhere. And most of these farms in Africa and Asia are managed by women. They have limited resources. And to expect them to adopt those practices, which require them to provide different kind of inputs into the system, and yet serve the entire global community, it's not fair to expect them to do it. They have no resource to do it. They cannot do it otherwise. That's the policy. I think if we were to adopt these recommended practices by the large-scale farms that are in the US or small-scale holders in Asia and Africa, those ecosystem services payment might be an essential policy issue. That's what I mean by translating science into action.